I really wish, you know, I really wish I was at the U.S. Open right now. I'm looking forward to U.S. Open. I always look forward. That's probably my favorite tournament. Yeah, it's just, you know, it's not just a tournament. That's why when they thought about changing the location, I was like, no, don't do that. The U.S. Open is like me. You got to keep it there. That's what it's all about. That's what makes it the U.S. Open is the lake, too. I get a lot of texts, you know, people hear about Denny Brouwer, all these people, all these big anglers that I didn't tell, as soon as I went, they're texting me. So it does go around pretty quick that, you know, who wins the U.S. Open. So it is a national tournament.
The U.S. Open was one of the very, very first, if not the very, very first $50,000 first prize tournament. As we fished that tournament, it kind of evolved into more than just a good check or a good prize. For the first time ever, we started to bring the East Coast fishermen and the West Coast fishermen into one event that had never been happening before. But this brought us all kind of together, and what that did for the sport was really significant, and that is that it actually started bringing knowledge from different techniques and the sharing of that knowledge together. We started to kind of learn about each other and start to respect that each of all of the anglers in the United States. It also brought in a lot of international fishermen, so they had started to have an international flavor, especially those out of Japan. Final thing in the U.S. Open that the U.S. Open meant was that due to the time of the year it was held out at Lake Mead in July and August, due to the fact it was probably the longest, it was a four-day event when it was first held, it became kind of what I call the Iditarod of bass fishing, that it would test your angler being mind, body, and soul. It was a tremendous physical test because of the extreme heat that you would have in July and August. It went on for 4 days. You were up at 4:30 every morning, and you were fighting the elements, four long days. The lake itself is not an easy lake from a fishing standpoint, so it was challenging. Everything you had, all your resources had to come into play for you to succeed in that tournament. So it became really a true test of where you were at as a professional angler.
The U.S. Open is one of the most important tournaments that I can fish on the West Coast. It gives you the biggest exposure, the most visibility, and it's got the biggest purse.
The U.S. Open was basically the start of my career. It's what made me a professional angler. It was a springboard, you know, winning it the first time at 27 years old. It basically introduced me to the sponsors, introduced me to the professional anglers that were there, and it was neat to have all the BASF guys and every one of my idols, from Zell Rowland to Rick Flynn, Denny Brouwer, the Hibbins back then. I mean, it was to me a star-studded field of everybody I ever read and dreamed about meeting. And actually beating those guys, you know, at 27, the first time, that's what changed my life and kind of encouraged me to make a career out of being a professional angler. It really was the start of the whole thing for me.
As a kid growing up in fishing, when I was 15, 16 years old, 17, it was the biggest tournament in the country. I wanted to win that term. When I dream about winning a big term, I wanted to win U.S. Open. I never dreamed about Bassmaster Classics or anything like that. I always wanted to win the U.S. Open because it was truly the toughest test in bass fishing. It was 4 days long, the heat of the summer. It just had all the elements of just being brutally tough fishing. And so it was a childhood dream to me, dream of mine to win it. So that's what it means to me. It's something that I hold near and dear as far as wanting to fish it and be there and enjoy it every time.
U.S. Open is pretty special to me. I was fortunate to win in 2008, so to me it's helped my career tremendously, and I won't miss it.
It's made me some money.
The U.S. Open's always been something I would go out and say, okay, do I still have what it takes to compete at a high level? And So in many ways, I used it as a, you know, where am I weak at? Am I mentally, you know, weak? Do I need to work on that part? Am I physically need to get in better shape? So to me, it's just became the ultimate test. And as far as it meant to me, I think, again, it connected me to the West Coast guys. So not only did I get to know them, they got to know me. Here about six years ago, ESPN conducted the world's greatest angler debate, where the fans actually voted on over a year time frame who was the best angler ever. And I actually won that award on ESPN. I was voted the world's greatest angler. And I really think, to be honest with you, it was probably a tight race between me and Roland Martin. But I really think what gave me the win was my winning the U.S. Open. Well, Roland and I was probably pretty equal when it came to other events in the country, other major showcase events. Roland had never won the U.S. Open. Roland was not probably as looked at as highly as I was by the West Coast anglers, and I really think the West Coast vote is what kind of tipped that the scales in my favor and allowed me to win that honor.
The U.S. Open has helped me in getting major sponsors, which is Evergreen International. And
the U.S. Open has always been like the very first win. You know, you chalk that up as your big win, and winning it twice, you know, definitely solidified me as a Western angler and a national angler, because when I won the tournament both times, there were a lot of the guys from back east that were still fishing it, and for me, it was a career maker. They talk about breakers and makers, and I'll tell you, that made my whole career start off, because I could walk around and tell people, you know, I have a title, not just one title, but two titles, two U.S. Opens, and you know, that gets the sponsors interested, and you know, you can call yourself a U.S. Open champion for the rest of your life, or a two-time U.S. Open champion for the rest of your life, and I'm just proud to be a part of the event every year I can go to it. And I always look back fondly at the springboard of my professional angling career.
Well, the U.S. Open established me in the West as when I was fishing in the West in the late 90s, it established me as, you know, a top professional at that time. I had got second twice, once in the 80s, once in the 90s. I got third. I've been close. And when I finally broke through in 97, it just gave me that credibility. It was the top title in the Western United States, and then to win it again a couple years later just solidified that. So yeah, it's just it's the one title that most of the guys who grew up fishing out west still look to as, you know, the most legitimate big title out in the Western United States.